video, I'm going to show how to set a shower pan liner and pour pan. And I'm going to let you know all the stuff you need in advance so that you're prepared, same as I am here. You're going to need some type of drill. You're going to need some screws for the drill. These are sheetrock screws. It doesn't really matter which ones. You're going to need a little open-end wrench. You're going to need a razor knife of some sort, a mask, so when you mix the mortar, you're going to need some caulking, some silicone caulking. I prefer white so I can see it. Gloves, although that's optional. You're going to need a whole bunch of different blades, including the trowel, a couple of sponges, and levels. Levels plural. There's never too many levels. In fact, this one here, I don't even use as a level. I use as kind of a screed board. And then I have a 5 foot level, 4 foot level, sorry. You're going to need a shovel. You're going to need a thought. You're going to need a mixing thing. Some people prefer a bucket. I don't. I like it out in the open. It's easier. I have a little play toy thing that I put my knees on. You're going to need some mortar. This is Quikrete mortar from Home Depot. It is a green stripe, which means that the next day you can kind of take your blade, your long 12-inch or 9-inch blade, and kind of, if you have some high spots. If you get the one with the red stripe, you're not going to be able to do that. They're also at Lowe's. There is another product. It's mortar mix also, but I like it. I like it a lot better. The sand particles are bigger. It's a little easier to work with, but I don't shop at the Blue Pill, so unfortunately I have this stuff. I have 4 bags. This is about roughly almost 5. It's basically 4 foot, almost 4 foot by 4 foot shower, more or less. And so 4 bags should do it. I always have an extra one. I have it downstairs just in case I need it. It's better to have it than not. You're going to need a couple of things of water, mostly for rinsing over there. So that's kind of the tools you're going to get started with. And you're going to need your shower pan liner, of course. This is a much larger liner than what I need. I think this is a 6x7 or 6x6. That might be 6x6. So I have 2 extra feet of room going up both ways, which is what I want. And to get started, I'm going to take this drain, pull it off. Open end wrench is what. That's why I have the tape on there, so I know which one it is that fits these bolts. You're going to take this off. And you're going to clean it of all the dust. Get all that dust free and clear, because you're going to run a bead of caulking up under that ridge that's under here that I'm going to show you. Right there. This ridge right here, you're going to have to put caulking on that. So you're going to have to get up all your dust. Take off these bolts. Make sure you don't drop them in the drain. I'm going to try and hyphenate this video, whoops, as much as possible. But it might run a little long, so bear with me. There's a lot of people that have questions that you may not have. And so I don't lose them, I just put it on there and put it right there. And then, usually I have a shop vac that I do this with, but I don't have it handy and set up already. So I'm just going to do it that way. So, what I usually suggest is doing a dry fit of your pan liner to make sure it completely goes over your curb and make sure that it goes at least 6 inches up your wall. Typically your pan liner should be 2 inches above your curb. This is about 4.5. So yeah, you want your pan liner to at least go up to this level right here. Another reason I put the blocking in is so it gives you the parameter of where that is. But blocking is always kind of required. Not required. Preferred. I'll put it like that. Anyway, pan liner goes next, and I'm going to set this camera the best way I can to show you how this is done. I get a lot of questions on how to do folds at pan liners. Oh, by the way, I don't do pre-slope either. Don't ask me about that in the comment section. I'm not going to answer it because I waterproof my shower pan surface. Therefore, the pre-slope is a moot issue and unnecessary. We'll be right back. There's a lot of people that prefer the circle, cutting a circle around it. I'm not one of those people. I feel it's unnecessary to cut a circle when you can just as easily cut an X. And that goes for your bolt holes also. Once that's done, you put your drain cap on. See how the flaps are pushed down? That's why I like doing the X. That's just me. Back off of it till you hear a click. Right there. That way you have a positive thread. I roll that down about an inch and a half before it hits bottom, because the perimeter of my mortar is going to fill up that area, probably at the perimeter about 2 1/4 inches or so. So about a 3/4 to an inch drop from the perimeter down to where we're at with the barrel of drain. And that's basically it. That's how you put the drain in and you make it waterproof. There's no water that's going to leak through that. Now I'm going to go forward with setting my pan liner and screwing out all the edges and doing the cutting and all that stuff. So hopefully you'll follow this. I'm gonna go to the hospital.
Shorty came in and she got me red-handed, creeping with the girl next door. Picture this, we were both butt naked, banging on the bathroom floor. How could I forget that I had given her an extra key? All this time she was standing there, she never took her eyes off me.
How you thinking to open access to your villa? Trespass on a weakness, all the luck clean on your pillar. You better watch your mouth before she turn into a killer. Yes, so do the situation that you call the winner. To be a cool player, you have to know how to play. Each is say a night, convince her say a day. Never admit to a word that she say. And if she came, you tell her, baby, no way.
But she got me on the counter. Saw me banging on the sofa. I even had her in the shower. She even caught me on camera. She saw the marks on my shoulder. Heard the words that I told her. Heard the screams getting louder. She stayed until it was over. Honey came in and she caught me red-handed, creeping with the girl next door. Picture this, we were both butt naked, banging on the bathroom floor. I had tried from what she was about to see. Why should she believe me when I told her it wasn't me? On my shoulder.
Wasn't me.
Heard the words that I told her.
Wasn't me.
Heard the screams getting louder.
Wasn't me.
She stayed until it was over. Honey came in and she got me red-handed, creeping with the girl next door. Picture this, we were both butt naked, banging on the bathroom floor. How could I forget that I had given her an extra key? All this time she was standing there, she never took her eyes off me.
Oh, you thinking to open access to your villa? Trespass on a weakness, all the luck clean on your pillar. You better watch your mouth before she turn into a killer. Yes, you do the situation that you call the winner. To be a cool player, you can know how to play. Each is say a night, convince her say a day. Never admit to a word that she say. And if she came, I'll tell her, baby, no way.
But she got me on the counter. Saw me banging on the sofa. I even had her in the shower. She even got me on camera. She saw the marks on my shoulder. Heard the words that I told her. Heard the screams getting louder. She stayed until it was over. Honey came in and she got me red-handed, creeping with the girl next door. Picture this, we were both butt naked, banging on the bathroom floor. I had tried to keep her from what she was about to see. Why should she be?
And that is the end. That's the finish. That's how easy and quick a pan liner is set. You can see it probably goes about 18 inches up the back wall, which is okay. It goes way above the left and right wall, which is fine. And the hospital folds in the corner at the front. Hospital folds in the corner at the back. And I always tuck them on the inside. That's as easy as it gets. Right now, that's a waterproof pan. So if you wanted to, you do a flood test at this point, let it set overnight, put a plug inside where the drain is at. Once the plug is in the drain, then you're going to be able to go ahead and pour your mortar the next day. I don't run into those issues. I do the same redundancy every job, so I know this is 100% waterproof. And I'm going to start doing my mortar now.
You certainly need a lot of confidence in your trade.
Yeah, cymbals, chimp, bongo, tambourine.
What are these things?
These are clays.
What are they for?
Set a rhythm for the Latin American stuff. Here, let me show you.
See? Very simple. Very simple.
Something to sit your tile on, so you want your mortar bed to be sloped. And the way I do it, and I've done it over the years, is exactly what you're watching right now. I start out just kind of moving all this mortar around to where I want it, to where I think it'll be. Doesn't mean it's the only way. If you wanted to, you could use a board. You could just kind of screed it off, you know, like exactly where you want it to be, which everybody has their own way of doing this. You could even put a black magic marker. You could draw yourself a line right on the back and a black magic marker exactly the height that you want this mortar to be, and then just go up to there. You could put it a screed board. So a screed board would be something like this, except it would be tapered down incrementally to that quarter inch per foot. You would have to cut a lot of these, at least four, and you would stick them inside the mortar just like that, and the height that you want it. So it'd be about 2 inches over here, and it dropped down to about 1.25 inches down to here, and you would cut it off at that point. Then you just pack your mortar all the way to the top of the board. If the board was sitting flush with the mortar, you pack your mortar on top of it. You screed off these four little sections, or six if you wanted to. And then when you're finished, you just pull the board out, let that dry up a little bit, and then fill in where the board was at. So there are different methods. You could also do a board at the back. You could set it inside of the back here at the height that you wanted it. So let's say I wanted it 3.5 inches, then that's where I would have all my four boards at, and I would level those boards out first, and then I would just pack my mortar all the way up to the top of that, and then pull out the boards afterward, and same thing, fill in the gap. Again, not the way I prefer. You got to do what's easiest.
Having got that into our sampler, we play it.
Right on cue.
Outstanding.
Pretty cool.
I was able to start just making exactly what was in my mind again.
so you're wondering where the level kicks in. Now it does. I usually do all my packing and screening and everything I can possibly do prior to ever putting a level on it. And usually I'm very, very close to being on level. In this case, I'm not. So, put a little bit more mortar up in this area. This is where my low spot's at. Much better. That one right on. That one's right on. And that one, low spots over there.
Thank you.
So basically you saw me work this mortar actually quite a bit more than I usually do. Sometimes things give you problems, and in this case that corner area over there was giving me problems. So what you're trying to end up with is a nice even flat sloped but flat shower pan. So as I was doing earlier, I was putting a level on all four sides. I'm level there, that's what I want. I'm level there, that's what I want. And when I say flat, I mean your level is going across the pan without any dips or humps or anything like that. Want it back there, which is level, and it's flat. Although there's a very, very slight gap over here, I'm not really worried about that. My thin set will take up that difference. And then in the back, if I can get back there, the level back there. And you want to be flat. So what this was doing is giving me a lot of problems because it wasn't flat. Now I can clearly see that it's flat now, and it has a slight gap there where it drains down. And by the way, your bubble is all the way to the back as much as possible. Not all the way to the back necessarily. In some cases it will be. So I end up with that same gap toward the end of my level on all four sides, which is exactly what I want. And it's flat, so there's no dips or any humps or anything like that going on with that offset bubble. And it should be the same way all the way around. And then what I do, a lot of other tilers don't do it, what I do is I leave a little room there for my tile, my thin set, and my tile, so that my tile sets slightly above where the drain cap is, so I can do a taper cut on all the tile going around it. And then, I know I told you to have a lot of levels, and I haven't got all my levels out, which is kind of weird. So you want to make sure that your drain cap is level too. So I'm level that direction, and I'm level that direction as well. I don't know if you can see it. And so this is ideally what you want before you ever get started putting wallboard up or doing tile or anything like that. This is the easiest way I know. And again, many, many variations and many, many different levels. Many variations on how to do a pan. There's no one right way to do it. However it works best for you. I showed you my way. I showed you a couple examples of other ways you can do it. You can go, you know, go on YouTube and find out if somebody else has a better way. A lot of guys, what they'll do is they'll pack their mortar, maybe 2 or 3 inches of mortar outside of their perimeter first. They'll get inside the pan area because there's no mortar in there yet. They'll pack all that down, put a level on it, get that perimeter pack going on, flat and all that stuff, and then start screeding off of that their slope down to the drain. That's a little slower for me. The way I do it, when I just throw my mortar around and kind of figure out where I need it, I'm almost always level, with the rare exception that I had here up front earlier. I'm almost always level all the way around anyway, so it doesn't serve me to get all that perimeter part packing done first. I just feel this is the easiest way for me. But there you go. How to set a shower pan liner and how to put mortar in it so you're ready for tile. This should set up ideally in my world about 3 days before I start putting wallboard up and you know, red guarding and everything, about third to maybe fourth day. Ideally this should set up a week or longer. A couple weeks would be good. In this case, this will be setting up for I think 5 days before I do anything to it. You can put a fan on it, but don't put directly on it. Just have the circulation of the fan somewhere out in this area. Don't put the fan directly on it. And there you go. That's the easiest way that I know to show you how to do this. Hey, if you enjoyed that video and you learned something, consider being a Patreon member. $5, $10, $15 a month would help me greatly produce more videos. I make nothing from YouTube at all. If you're going to call me for advice, please donate $50 for 30 minutes. My link to my PayPal and my Patreon account is down below. And if you haven't already, hit the subscribe button and hit the bell so you get immediate notifications as soon as I post a video. And thank you very much for your support.